Yes, hello everybody and welcome to Off The Bench. Great to have your company, proudly produced by TAC, supporting community footballers. I welcome this man, the Kaji Greaves medalist, manager to the Stars, Liam Pickering. Welcome, Pix.
Good to be here, Sammy, and looking forward to having a chat about country footy. I know the last week that, unfortunately, with the COVID situation, wasn't any games on, but we can do a bit of a summary of the year so far. I think that could work for us.
Indeed. We've got another couple of players to add to our team of the 2010s. We've got a massive show in store, our country town in the spotlight, and pick something of an elephant in the room because, I'll get to this early, you made some comments a fortnight ago at this very program that had our switchboard light up like a Christmas tree.
What was that? What comments have I made?
We'll get to it in a moment because rest assured, the natives are restless. We'll get to that shortly. I tell you what, we can't get to it soon enough because the switchboard, our talkback and our people who man the phones here will be happy we can put this to bed later on in the program. But we need to start where we always do, and that is with this, the Country Footy Roundup. And we're going to a big league, one of the biggest leagues in country, Victoria, of course, picks the Bendigo Footy League. As you say, no games at the weekend, but we can take stock of where this league sits, and it is a big one.
They've been a powerhouse, haven't they, Strathfield Say, over the last few years, and they're up on top again. Big percentage, 230%. Ooh. Going very, very well. And then you look at Sandhurst, been having a good season. And Golden Square, very, very good traditional team. South Bendigo rounding out with Gisborne, the top five. The Kyneton boys under Paul Chapman not going as hot as I would have liked.
Chappie. Message not getting through from Chappie?
Well, I think they're a pretty young team this year. They lost a few players. So,
yep.
And then there's a couple of other. Castlemaine obviously having a tough year. You know, percentage of 17 and just no wins from their game so far. But
this is Golden Square and Sandhurst going back a couple of weeks ago. Golden Square getting the job done quite easily.
It's a good football competition, this one. It's a nice competitive country league. It's one of the better country leagues in Victoria, and some good teams and some good footballers coming out of this area. Don't worry about that.
Yeah, it's produced some rippers, hasn't it, over the journey, has the Bendigo Football League. And looks like
I've played at Golden Square.
Yeah.
I've played at that.
Happy with the surface there?
We played a practice match years ago when I was playing for Geelong against, I reckon we played against Brisbane.
Yeah, okay.
We played against the Bears back then. It might have been when I was playing at North, but it's a great footy town, as we know, Bendigo. We had it on focus the other week. We talk about how many players that they've produced that are AFL stars across the years, but no, it's a good competition.
Yep, Strathfield Say, as you say, on top of the ladder, the reigning premiers. In fact, I think they've won four of the last six flags in that league, going beautifully. The Ellenbank and District Footy League picks. We'll have a look at this one next. This
is look at Ellenbank out on top.
Undefeated.
Undefeated, going great guns at the moment. So, yeah, they look the team to beat, clearly the team to beat. Look at that, undefeated and a percentage of 245. You go all the way down to Lang Lang in fifth spot.
Yep.
Long Warrior, well, they've the reigning premiers. They need a little bit of work where they're sitting at the moment. Four games behind the top of the table, Ellenbank, and Poo Wong just out of the five at the moment. And so don't be surprised if they sneak in. Their percentage needs a bit of work, but a couple more wins. There won't be many games left either. The season's getting away from us. Yarragon have had a tough year. It's fair to say at the bottom.
But regional Victoria coming out of lockdown as
yes, well. Yes, they'll so be playing this weekend,
they'll be
which
playing
is good.
This weekend, which is unbelievably good news. All right, let's get to the elephant in the room, picks, because have you stirred up a hornet's nest? You said this a couple of weeks ago.
What? It'd be like going and playing, you know, your home ground, it's like this MCG, which is Saul, and then you go to Minyat Matar and it's like playing at a dog track,
yeah.
To be honest.
So that's you calling the Minyat Matoa Football Ground a dog track. I tell you
well,
what,
it is compared to Stall. Stall's a much better ground.
Before the switchboard lit up, our communications team, the emails were running hot. We nearly had a logjam in there at the email. We got this feedback for you, Pix, explicitly. Let's have a look at this. Dear Pickers, I'm sending a formal complaint about your comments re the condition of the Minyip Oval on last week's show. In fact, I'm a part of the Minyip Recreation Reserve Committee and we take a huge amount of pride in our ground where Minyip Matoa belted Stall by 10 goals.
Nice yes, they did.
By for you there.
Wasn't that much, but they did beat us pretty
Please early. See the following photos of our oval to back our comments up of being one of the better surfaces in the Wimmera. So okay. Here's the attached photos. Oh, my goodness. I tell you what, Pix.
Yeah.
I host the bowl show, and I don't see surfaces this good on the bowl show. Have a look at that deck.
Yeah, the deck looks you a lot better than last time I was there, I must say. It was a long time ago.
There's a photo of Minyip Matoa just slicing through Stall like a knife through butter. most recently in that 10-goal thumping.
Well, just it's a doctored photo. I mean, obviously, they had they picked one good shot out from the day, but no disrespect to Minute Matoa. It's they're a very good football club.
Oh, jeez.
And I will say this, though. I mean, when you're comparing the MCG, which is Central Park in Stawell, where they run the Stawell gift, the prestigious Stawell gift...
No, just on that, our author of this particular correspondence had this to say about your old home ground. Let's go on for some further comments in this email. Right. I hope you've done your homework this week to see that Minute Matoa doubled Stawell's score on Saturday in what was a muddy wicket area and slippery surface in Stawell.
Yeah.
I feel that you have become too much of a city snob, and I wonder if you have been to a town that doesn't have an airport in the last 30 years. Cheers, Frenchie. Love
it. Well, Frenchie, I do remember chatting with Frenchie at the race.
Yes, because he said Menangatang.
No. Well, they're great people in the Wimmera. I know that. And they're having a bit of fun, and that's fine, Frenchie. And I appreciate what you're saying. And I haven't been to the ground, in fairness, since 1987. So it's been a long time.
You're backtracking then on your comments that it's a dog track?
The ground looks pretty good. I was just doing it as a bit of fun because I was pumping up Stawell's ground. But, Frenchie's taking a bit of offence, but that's OK. I'll see it at one of our country racing marquees soon.
Well, no, you'll see him sooner than that because he's actually joining us on the line. Frenchie's been good enough to get in touch with us here via Zoom. Frenchie, welcome.
What's this?
Hey, Sam Pickers, how you going?
Hey, Frenchie, how you going, buddy?
Pickers has backflipped at a rate of knots, Frenchie. Has that calmed your farm or are you still a bit irritated?
Oh, look, I knew once he remembered the size of me, he would have backtracked as well, but... No, definitely become too much of a snob and probably, we won't see him in Minute for probably another 30 years, I'm guessing.
Well, it was 1986 or 1987 when I was last there and I caused an all in blue actually in 1986. I sat Dean Hotker on his backside on the centre wing in my first year in senior footy and fair to say they came for me, but I had some protection around me luckily. So that was actually not so bad, but I've only been there a couple of times, Frenchie, but... didn't have a lot of great memories from a junior days, the under-16s, but, yeah, I haven't been there for a long time, mate. I was having a bit of fun.
No, it's all in fun, but we've spent a lot of time there in the last couple of years and getting the service up to where it is today, and we're quite proud of it. And even my phone ran hot because I missed the show at the time, but everyone was pretty quick to let me know that what was being said.
Well, you can take it from me. I was having a bit of fun. That's sort of how I play it, Frenchie, and you know that because I have had a few beers with you before. But, it is. Your team's going well, mate. They're actually having another good season.
No, definitely flying along and only had the one loss this year again by 1 point. So fingers crossed we can get the season across the line and have a fair crack in the finals.
Have you guys gone local again? Have you got your juniors program up and going? Is that why you're so strong? You've been strong for a number of years now.
Yeah, that's been the big one. We've even been able to debut a 16-year-old in the last couple of weeks and he stood out in his first game. So we're pretty lucky that way that everything we seem to be doing is ticking along really well.
Well, I think that's really important, Sammy. Now, Sammy is a city snob. I'm not. I'm a country boy.
Come again?
You're a city slicker.
I'm a peninsula slicker. No, I'm a bit each way. I've got a foot in either camp.
Now, Frenchie, let me just give you a little heads up here of what Sammy is. He thinks he's country because he grew up in Sorrento. Now, it's not really what we call country, is it? Sorrento.
No, definitely not. And to be honest, Sam did mention up there at the cow paddock as well the other day. I noticed he did... What? Cut that little snippet out of the pre-show part there.
Yeah, well, of course he did. See, this is what happened. Backfire on you. We stick together in the window.
I don't recall that at all, Frenchie. My memory has failed me. Hey, well done on your team's form, though, so far this season. And most of all, they're doing it on one of the best services I've ever seen in country footy. That's a credit to you and your committee. Hey, thanks for being a good sport and jumping on, Frenchie. Best luck for the rest of the season.
Thank you, guys. Good luck to you too.
Frenchie joining us there. He is going to be doing a magnificent
good
work.
Good stitch up, you blokes.
Up there at Minute Matoa.
You and Kane out the back. There's going to be words after this show.
I like the way you tried to flip it on me, though. That was most impressive. That's the manager coming out in you. You just tried to divert us ever so slightly.
That's exactly how we roll, and that's how we should roll.
I was a bit disappointed in you, though, because I remember you as a player. You were never scared of a dust-up. Let's have a look. You more than happy to roll the sleeves up and time to time and get involved in the fisticuffs, and we saw nothing of this from you today.
Well, because Frenchie, I mean, I didn't want to disrespect his footy club.
Poor old David King there copying.
Oh, Kingy off to the sick bay. Oh, there you go, Kingy.
What about poor old Libba in the hands of the trainers and you wind him out?
Stay out of the way, Libba. Jingo, where are you getting these highlights from?
Jeez. And yet we get Frenchie in and you fold like a deck of cards.
Have you seen the size of Frenchie? He's a huge man. I'm not that silly.
Hey, if he says I called it a cow paddock, I believe him. I'm not arguing with him either, although I don't remember that. Hey, we're off and running here on Off the Bench. A massive show still to come. Well, who am I? We haven't even got to that yet. That's on the other side of this. And it's all thanks to TAC Club Rewards. You can earn up to $10,000 for your community footy club in 2021. Welcome back to Off the Bench. We've had a rollicking start here to this week's show, thanks to the TAC supporting community football. Liam Pickering has just started to get the shakes under control after Big Frenchie joined us. That was good of you to face up to that, Picks.
Well, I didn't realise it was going to happen, but it was a nice little stitch-up by you and the team out the back. But anyway, that's all right. I had my say, and yep. Frenchie was able to sort of fire back, which was good.
It was very good. I enjoyed it immensely. I enjoy this immensely too. It's time for Who Am I, Picks, which you've had your ups and downs with,
you
said.
You know, I've got one that I didn't get because of Ron Barassi's question.
All right, here we go. Here's a first clue, a telling one. Played, coached over 700 games.
Thank you.
Yep. Not a bad little start. You'll have your ideas. Coached two AFL teams in different states.
Two AFL teams.
Want to have a crack?
Nah, Ayrsie didn't quite get to that many, I don't think.
You don't have a crack, do you, unless you absolutely know.
10's 200, he wouldn't have played 500. Awarded the Australian Sports Medal. Mick Mouldias, he coached three teams though, so it's not him.
Let's roll on with clue number four then. He is in the AFL Hall of Fame.
Wouldn't be Ron Barassi. So from Warrigal, there he is. He's the only one I can think of from Warrigal, but he wouldn't have had that many games. Is he played about 280? He coached Adelaide and Geelong.
Think he might be onto something.
I'm onto Ayrsie, but I didn't realise. Don't know how many.
Is it Warner? My nickname was Conan.
Yeah, well, it's Gary Ayres, so I got it. But 700 games. What a great career. What a fantastic footballer. 5 day, 5 night too, by the way. He never gets that title. And he's got two norms to go with it.
I was just going to say, he was a man for the big occasions. Hawthorn best and fairest, Hall of Fame we mentioned, and a two-time VFL premiership coach. But it's just come to an end at Port Melbourne, which is a whole other
story. I know. He's a great man, Gary Ayres. He was a fantastic footballer, tough footballer.
Yep.
Good coach. I enjoyed him as a coach at Geelong.
You had your Liptacs and your Jarmans.
You had your Hawkins and your Bairstows and your Couches and your Ablets. Gary Ayres, great player. He won two Norm Smith medals in different positions. He won one on the wing playing on David Rees-Jones, and then he won one in the back pocket, his familiar position, but a fabulous player. I wouldn't have thought he had 700. That was the only thing I was worried about, because he would have played 300 games probably.
No, I don't think it said VFL AFL games. AFL games,
aren't. He played and coached over 700 games.
Yes.
Oh, well, you.
Well, read the question.
I know he's coached 10 years at AFL level. He coached five at Geelong and
five. You've still got it. Don't be hard on yourself.
Well, I'm not hard on myself. I'm trying to work out what the clues were.
Hey, I respected the hair, though, because the locks didn't go anywhere. While the years wore on, the locks remained.
Do you know what I loved about it? When Ayrsie started to go a little bit grey and he was coaching the Cats, and our pre-game attire was a pair of tan pants and a white shirt and a blazer like this, and we'd turn up to every game in a tie. Ayrsie was coaching, he'd be sitting in the room, and he would have coloured his hair, of course, and then you'd walk out of the team meeting room and Brad Scholey or someone would say, look at the back of Ayrsie's neck. The old dyed run on the back of his neck.
Oh, no.
And he was getting a sweat up and a little bit of colour on the back of his white shirt before a game, which was quite interesting at times.
Players would have been really forgiving about that too.
Well, we thought it was pretty funny. I don't know how many people were game to bring it up, but great person, Gary Ayres. Love Ayrsie as a bloke. And he was a damn good coach too.
Well played by you, Gary Ayres, our Who Am I for this week. Also this week, Picks, one of my favourite segments, Great Country Footy Goals. Let's get
where
to
where we're going.
We're going to the Geelong Football League, and we're going specifically to Leopold and Newtown and Chilwell, the match in question here, and it's William Robinson.
There's Willie boy, good goal, son. Off this little banana there, number 21, the Dean Wallace, famous 21 at the Bombers. And then we'll have a look at another one here, and this is Mitch Patton, who...
Who's
Mitchie's? What's he had a look at? Little tap over. Great team play. Look at that. Bit of a don't argue and bang on the left.
I like that. And that sealed the win too. That was at a crucial time of that game, as you can see there, late in the fourth to get the chocolates. Get his
yeah,
side
it's a
shut the gate.
Another good competition. It's another one of those good comps. So, yeah, no, good fun. Good fun. Well done to the both boys. Good goals.
Okay, we need to get to a break. On the other side of this picks, we're going to, I guess, induct our latest entrants into our team of the 2010s. And we are amassing a mighty football side here. So stay tuned to find out who's in next. It's all thanks to TAC Club Rewards. Earn up to $10,000 for your community footy club in 2021.
I was part of the L2P program as a driver, a learner driver. And Ian was my mentor. I was talking to the instructor and I was saying, you know, I don't have anyone to drive with at home.
I never had access to a car and I learned how to drive.
There's so much more to take away than just driving.
I want to put back and give someone the help that I never had, because you do make a difference.
Yes, welcome back to Off the Bench. With thanks to the TAC supporting community football, Liam Pickering has been in a lather over the ad break. Still not happy with the who am I. You know, you remind me of one of those kids you played backyard cricket with growing up where they're never out. You're never out.
That's if you ask my country mates, they'll agree.
They play cricket. No ball.
The cricket against me in the backyard, that was never... it wasn't the greatest sport going around, but the questions were doctored. If it was just AFL games, Gary Ayres coached and played 492
games. That's true,
games.
But guess what?
Over 700. I didn't know you were going to add any Port Melbourne coaching.
And when you start reading the clues properly, you'll be all the better for it when it comes to who am I. Right, up next, team of the 2010s. No such kerfuffle with this. It is an absolutely cracking lineup. We're formulating picks and we've got another two entrants to add today.
Yeah, we have. I mean, that team's looking pretty good at the moment. Asprey and Murphy in the back pockets. So we need a fullback, a centre-half forward, a ruckman, half-back flank and a wingman.
Well, we're going to start with a back flank today and we'll slot this man in nicely. BJ Brendan Goddard. Terrelgan, he is from St Kilda. He made his name.
He did.
Who could forget this massive grab on 2010 grand final?
Yeah, the first grand final, he was superb. Brendan Goddard. And we had a good record in the finish. You know, 334 games across two clubs. Mainly remembered at St Kilda, but he did some good stuff for the Bombers.
Super player at the Saints around this time.
He had a fantastic grand final. What did he win? The Eston Best and Fairest in 2013. He was a two-time All-Australian. He was the Bombers captain, as I mentioned.
Yep. And he famously the number one pick in 2002 when Carlton was stripped.
They were stripped of Brendan Goddard and Daniel Wells.
And
might have made
a
bit of a difference.
I'm not sure if it was his mum or his auntie who got up on draft day and said, go Blues, when the Saints had the first pick as a result. They were a Carlton family growing up.
Yeah.
They wanted him to get to the Blues.
Anything to bring Carlton into it for you. Let's put a ruckman in here. Let's go to a man from Deterang. Big boy, McAvoy.
Big boy.
He's been a terrific player.
You get the feeling he's never left Deterang either when you speak to him. He's as country as they get, Big Benny.
Yeah, he is. I've been to Deterang, Sammy. It's a nice little town. In fact, it's the Ben McAvoy Oval.
Is it really?
Well, it's definitely the grandstand on the Oval. It's
good surface?
Yeah, it was a nice little ground. It's right next to...
good, you've learnt your lesson.
Great, fantastic service. Great grounds right next to the racetrack because we did the races up there. The off-the-bench marquee and... Yeah, we went straight next to the ground. The guys were from the footy club were running the races.
The Hawthorne captain now is a two-time premiership player, of course, and the first players you see there since Keith Shea in 1945 to become the Hawthorne captain after playing for another club. Of course, he started the Saints.
Is that right? Okay, there you go.
It's trivia.
Well, he was good again on the weekend in the game against Collingwood. I thought him and Segler did a really good number on Brodie Grundy, but I'm happy with those two players to be added to the team. We haven't got many to go.
No.
As we said, we've only really got a fullback, a centre forward, and a wingman, and that's it, and a couple of interchanges. And we're going to have a look at the two teams, the 90s team versus the 2010s.
Who do you match up on? We'll have to pick a matchup.
I don't think there's a matchup for me. There's no one in that team slow enough.
Hey, Brendan Goddard from Terrelgan and Ben McAvoy from Deterang, two great local towns in country Victoria. Speaking of which, let's set our microscope picks on another great local town, country town in the spotlight time.
Where are we going?
Echuca and Moama up on the river there. Let's have a look at it. Populate, what a beautiful spot this is. You would have spent many a day away. Week on a houseboat up in this part of the world?
No, I've actually never been on a houseboat. But I've got old Craig Scholl used to run the houseboats there at Echuca. And I know a number of the boys have got properties up there that mates of mine, mainly North Melbourne mates of mine, to be honest.
That is a photo of the 1928 Premiership team. There you go. Right?
Okay.
Well, a green strip there. Yeah. So two footy teams, the Echuca Murray Bombers competing in the Goulburn Valley Football League and Echuca United who compete in the Murray Football League. And have a look at the alumni from this part of the world.
Yeah, Ollie Wines, who famously didn't want to go, best mates with Jack Viney, wanted to go to the Demons, but ended up going to the Power. Jack Viney, who grew up there, because Toddy, I reckon Toddy Viney left the AFL when Jack was a kid. And I reckon he went up there and I reckon he ran a caravan park, I think. And so Jack ended up growing up there, becoming great mates with Ollie Wines, but it's a fantastic football area. So no real surprise that we produced a lot of good AFL players.
Did I see Andrew Walker's name? I think he was from Echuca, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was there, absolutely. Michael there Braun, the West Coast Premiership player. Aidan Johnson, who had a run over at the Power. And Dan Connors, who one of Dusty's best mates.
Colourful career.
Colourful career, good mate of Swannies.
Yes.
I think they're playing together at the Peanut Farm at the moment, the two of them.
The what now?
St Kilda City's footy club.
The Peanut Farm?
They play at the Peanut Farm.
Okay.
Do you know what the Peanut Farm is?
No.
It's down near Luna Park.
Educate me during this advert.
Well, it's a little ground out the back of Luna Park.
Okay.
They call it the Peanut Farm, and there are a lot of peanuts that played there over the years too. Don't worry about that, including Dane Swan and Dan Connors.
You're watching Off the Bench with thanks to the TAC Club Rewards. You can earn up to $10,000 for your community footy club in 2021. Our Clash of the Week. Great to have country footy back. That's up next. It's been great to have your company on a somewhat colourful Off the Bench this week, and it's all made possible by the TAC supporting community football picks. The restrictions have been eased in our regional areas of the state, which is fantastic. Country football is back, and with that in mind, let's have a look at our Country Footy Clash of the Week. It's an absolute blockbuster. It's from the Loddon Valley Football League, and have a look at the credentials of these two sides at the moment, Midiamo and Bridgewater.
Well, the Superoos, Midiamo, and taking on the Mean Machine.
Mean Machine.
Who have, have lost one game, the Mean Machine, this year, but they have been a powerhouse.
And Midiamo won the last time they played, and as you can see, remain undefeated, 11 and zip. This one at John Forbes Oval picks.
Yeah, Johnny Forbes. I know Johnny Forbes well. He's a good man. A legend of Puma back in the day.
So Bridgewater 7th in 2019, but then they won 7 flags in a row prior to that. They are a powerhouse of this competition, and Midiamo are the reigning premiers.
I'm going for the Roos.
I am too.
For the Super Roos. We can't go for the...
Okay, I'm going for Bridgewater, the Mean Machine.
You're easily swung.
Yep. Well, I just remember they're known as the Mean Machine. Yes, I don't know why I didn't gravitate.
Journo, real swinging in the breeze type character.
You talk about swimming. You caved in spectacularly early on in this show.
I think I did.
Won't forget it. Hey, great to have your company here on Off the Bench. We'll see you next week. Have a good weekend.